Welcome to another Sports Tech video. My name is Amjad Ali and I'm a triathlete. In this video, I'll give you in-depth review and full tutorial of Magin 406 GPS Smart Bike Computer, which is a well-designed bike computer with numerous features. Watch this video till end, because I am going to share a special offer to you. I have used many bike computers, but C406 by Magin is most attractive, competitive, and advanced product in the entry-level market. Watch this video till end to understand all the functions of Magin C406 bike computer, OneLabFit app, the physical installation, and then the test ride. The device itself is compatible with various sensors and can connect using ANT Plus and Bluetooth. These all sensors are optional, but it really helps you to monitor your performance in better way. Data screens are totally customizable, where you can add the data of your own choice. Okay, let us first open the box and see what is there inside this box. So let me open this box now. So it has various colors, as you can see, four colors are there. So I have chosen a red color because it matches my bike, but you can choose any color that characterizes your taste. So here is the clamp. So this clamp is used to attach to handlebar. I will also show you how I installed on my bike. So here is the USB cable. The user manual is here and the rubber ring. Okay, these are all the accessories that were there in the box. It's the only the second bike computer in the world designed with the aerodynamics principles. Before using, I will be charging it. I'll plug the USB cable in. The built-in battery of C406 is 3.7 volt, which is 1000 mAh. Till the time it gets charged, let us see all the specifications of Magin C406 Smart Bike Computer. As I mentioned, it has four colors, red, blue, orange, and black. Screen size is 2.5 inch black and white. It has four satellite positioning system, GPS, Beidou, GLONASS, and Galileo, which helps to track in challenging environment. It has dual protocol, ANT Plus and Bluetooth, which helps you to connect with various devices. If it is raining outside, you can still use it because it is having IPX6 waterproof rating. Talking about battery, it has ultra battery life and it takes 3.5 hours to fully charge the battery, and then you can have an endurance ride of 30 hours. The standby time is more than half a year. So total weight of sensor is just 18 grams and total with the clamp, it's 29 grams. I can see that the charging has completed now, so I will just simply remove it. So power button is on bottom left. Now I'll turn it on. Press and hold the power button, so it will give a beep, so it has turned on. Let me bind this with app to configure everything. So I'll open Magin Utility, agree to privacy tips, and then it will open this page, add new device, make sure that Bluetooth is turned on. So it will ask for the activation of device, enter your email ID and get the code, and then you will get the code by email, enter the code and start activating it. It has now successfully activated, and now you can press and hold the bottom right button in order to bind it with the app. Magin has recommended to use OneLabFit. So I will search for OneLab. It will show you three applications: OneLab, OneLabFit, OneLab Utility. OneLabFit is the application that we are going to use with this bike computer. Okay, now OneLab is downloading, and I will recommend to register your account before you start using the app. Okay, I have registered my account. I'll be binding this with the mobile. Press and hold this button. It will give a beep and it will give me a message that the device is connected. Now the device is connected. The first step after connecting the device is to update the firmware. So we will do the firmware update first. It will let us know that firmware is available. So I'll be updating the firmware. Okay, while firmware is being updated, don't close the screen or other apps, as it can interrupt the firmware update. And C406 will keep blinking till the time a firmware is being updated. So let me wait for the update to complete. Okay, now update is 100% completed. Now I'll tap on got it. When you turn the device on, it will give you a message on your screen that bike computer is connecting And once the bike computer is connected, it will give you a message that bike computer is connected. And then you can see the battery of your device, which proves that, okay, bike computer is connected to your app. First, I will tap on the page setup. Magin 406 has rich data of 37 items of 9 different categories, including power, cadence, speed, heart rate, grade, distance, altitude, time and turn counts. So there are 3 pages right now, which are preset programs. So you cannot change these preset programs. You can create your own program. I'll be configuring my own data pages. Data pages are nothing but the screens, 3 different kind of screens I can swap. So I want to configure my own data pages. So custom display pages. So I'll copy existing pages and it will create my own program. I'll give it a name, for example, SyncPrix. Just tap on the data field and you will get the option from the list. For example, I want to display the heart rate, so I will add the heart rate. And if I want to display the cadence, I'll choose the cadence. Similarly, elevation, speed, calories, temperature, power, and many other data fields can be chosen on your design pages. Customizing is very simple because you are going to use the app instead of using the device itself. Okay, now I have set up the data fields, so I'll apply and okay. It will update the new pages to C406 device directly with a message on your app that updated successfully. It will also give you a beep on the device, so which will prove that settings are applied. So let us go to the sensors right now. Let us first pair this heart rate sensor, which is H603. So I have already made a tutorial of this. So I'll be pairing H603 heart rate sensor here. I have cadence and speed sensor both, but I'll be configuring only cadence sensor. So detailed video of Magin S3 Plus speed sensor and cadence sensor is also provided here, so you can watch this. Okay, now the heart rate sensor and the cadence sensors are paired. So page setup that I have already explained you, and then sensors are already done. Now I'll be taking you to functions. Time zone, it has already detected UTC+4. Elevation calibration, it will automatically detect when the GPS signals are available. So the moment sun will rise, the backlight will turn off. The moment sun will set, backlight will turn on. You can also turn on the backlight by holding top left button. So it will turn on the backlight, as you can see. And if I press and hold this, it will turn off the backlight. Auto power off, I will keep this powered on. Auto pause, if the speed of your bike goes 5 km/h or less than this, it will automatically pause. I want this feature because sometimes when I want to take rest or I take break, I want the device to automatically pause my ride. Tones, I want to turn all the tones on. Recording reminder, so if you are not recording the data, bike computer will remind you that you have to start recording the data. Heart rate alarm, for example, if I go more than 180, I want the heart rate alarm also to be displayed. Profile, I have created my profile, so if you want to change the profile, you can change it. I have already authorized the app Strava. It will automatically upload the data to the app. So this was all about the One Lab Fit, and the device is now fully configured. Now I'll be taking you to my bike and I'll install it physically on my bike. Okay, here is C406 GPS Smart Bike Computer by Magin. I'll fix this clamp on the right side of my handlebar. Use the rubber ring first and then open the clamp and fix it. Just above the rubber ring, you have to fix it. Adjust the mount clamp position first and then tighten the screw. Place the computer in this way and just turn it to the clockwise so it will lock it. Check it by turning it on. Okay, to turn it on, you will press and hold the bottom left button, it will turn it on. It also has a symbol of power and the pause and play. So I'll just press and hold this for some time. It will turn on the device and give you a beep. To turn on the backlight, so I'll simply press and hold the button. So press and hold, it will turn on the backlight. Press and hold, it will turn off the backlight. So I will turn on the backlight for the time being to give you the demo. It will automatically turn on after sunset and turn off after sunrise using your GPS location, which is a great feature. And if you are pressing and holding this particular button, it will pair the device with your smartphone. So now this was all about pressing and holding. Simple operations of all these buttons is that if you want to start the ride, you will simply press this. It has started the ride now. And once you want to pause the ride, you will press this. It will pause the ride. And again, press this. So it will start the ride. While you are riding, so if you want to complete a lap or lap is completed, so you will simply press this button. So it will complete the lap. Now suppose I want to complete the ride, I can simply press and hold this. So it will stop the ride. And now my ride is completed.
You can of course use, if you press and hold this, it will pair with your phone, but if you press it once, it will change the page. So you can see third page, first page, second page.
So these three buttons, this one and these two buttons, there is no other configuration. There is no need to change anything. So everything can be done using the app. Now I'll be turning off this, press and hold. It will turn off and done. I am living in Oman, which is a sports-friendly country. Riding on weekends is great here. So let me go for a test ride now and I'll share with you details of my test ride.
So let me take a ride and I'll show you.
It gives me speed and then all the data fields that I customized. Total distance, which is 15.8 kilometers and then the total time since I'm riding. And then you can see the heart rate, which comes from the heart rate sensor. And then the average speed, 29.1 kilometer. And down there, I have kept the time so that I can keep monitoring the time and can turn back to my home. And then the cadence. Now I've started paddling. You will see the cadence is also there. So cadence sensor is attached over here with the crank. With Majin C406 bike computer, I have the heart rate sensor, which is already attached here. And this is sensing the heart rate data in real time while I'm riding.
Okay, I have just come back from the test ride and here is the data that I had. You can analyze the data of your ride directly on OneLab Fit app, like your speed, cadence, heart rate, elevation, power, and many other informative statistics. At the same time, it is automatically synchronized to Strava, which is seamless. So here is my test ride data, which looks perfect. Let us have a final thoughts of C406 bike computer. I must say Majin C406 smart GPS bike computer is perfect for those who are doing cycling, because you don't need any other device. You can also buy heart rate sensor and my recommendation is to use H603, which works perfectly. And if you're not interested to use speed sensor, I must say that go for the cadence sensor because it really helps to improve the performance by monitoring the cadence data. You can buy all of these items that I mentioned in this video and even which are not mentioned in this video, you can find them here in the description below. And don't forget to use the discount code. If you enjoyed this video, please give me a thumbs up and remember to leave any question or feedback in the comment section below. For more insights, watch this related video. Before you go, please subscribe to the channel and avoid missing any latest video. Take care and goodbye.